Hello everybody, it's a new season of the CRA, and there is no better place to kick it off than the Daytona 500, with its awesome banks and its incredibly long straights. It will give you 200 miles per hour plus racing in these huge packs. We love it. There's been one race here before. Matt's been dead or got the win here. But now, many months later, he starts a little deep in the pack. Let's see what's going to happen now. We have 20 laps. It's going to be pretty wreck-filled, maybe, because we do have 37 drivers, and all 37 are going to be looking for spots they can make up, and that might cause some big wrecks. So let's look at your track right here. As you can see, it's a tri-oval shape. We've got the long straight in the back. That's where most of our wrecks happen. That's where the cars go really fast. You might be able to get into the catch fence there. Anyways, let's look at your drivers to watch for. First of all, we have Chase Elliott. He starts on the pole today, very fast at qualifying. Next to him is Ross Chastain, another dark horse. Corey LaJoie, he did very good in qualifying for his equipment. Now let's see what he can do during the race. Daniel Suarez and Trackhouse Racing, a new team. I'm very excited to see, will they be very good, or will they be a caliber like Stewart House Racing? I mean, Rick Ware Racing, you know, something like that. De Benedetto, yeah, last winner right there. And Logano won CRA Season 3. And the other new team, 23 XI Racing, with Bubba Wallace as its driver. Here is your track layout. As you can see, we've got a very big, high-banked track. You see that there are the two straights, four turns, and they have lots of action to come with it. Here is your starting command.
Drivers, start your engine!
The cars will roll off here as we're going to get your starting grid going. Chase Elliott on the pole, as you can see. Chastain goes alongside him in row one. You can see the rest of the rows fill out here. Kyle Larson, there's one. He came back from suspension last year. Let's see what he can do now. RCR teammates in row six. And De Benedetto starting right there in around 20-ish. He won the last one, so he's definitely one to look forward to. Then with Suarez and Bubba Wallace, those two drivers that are in the new teams, they start pretty deep in the field, but we'll see if they can make their way up in the middle of the race. As the last of the rows fill out, the pace car is going to finish its last one. They come off, and the beginning of the new CRA season is here. Chase Elliott leads them down to the green flag, and here he goes on the inside lane with help from his teammate, Alex Bowman, but he moves up to the outside. In the Daytona 500, there is no help from the teammates. It's everybody for themselves. Well, Ross Chastain jumps up to the top. He was there anyway, but he's going to get the lead. Chase Elliott's already getting funneled all the way to the back in the sucker hole, only on lap two. From pole all the way to the back of the pack almost, as we see him getting funneled. Chastain already starting a little bit of a train on the outside lane. Truex leads the bottom, but he's quickly losing ground. Oh, Bowman tries to go up, but he wasn't clear, and now he's going to be put in the sucker hole. Hendrick Carr's not having a good day early. Chastain still in the lead. It looks like him and Bell jump down to the bottom, along with Truex, lap 5. Busher leads the outside. It looks like they jump up a little bit. Lap 6 now. Byron gets loose. Oh, he hits Chastain. Huge wreck on the front stretch. Caution is out, and the big one erupts on lap 6. Let's see this replay. Looks like Byron gets loose off of LaJoie. Hits Custer. Huge hit for him. And the field is coming. Everybody wanna
take her all the way. Ever dreamed of driving a real cup car? Well, now you can. This is the Fan Controller.
do? It's possessed.
That was completely inappropriate.
Some notable drivers out of the race, like rookie Chase Briscoe, you got Reddick, Byron, Almirola. A lot of the Stewart Haas drivers are already out. As we're going to take one more look at that wreck. A lot of cars do have to come in pit for repairs because they did suffer some minor damage during the wreck. Bubba Wallace, one of the notable ones in there. Denny Hamlin also did his sick repair, so he has to get into the back of that. And more green flag again. Chastain leading once again. He has dominated pretty much every single lap of this race, and it looks like he will dominate some more. Logano's going to give him the help on the inside. Oh, we got a caution! Harvick spins out of absolutely nowhere. We're going to see that replay. It looks like he comes down on Stenhouse when he wasn't supposed to, and he's going to have to go to the pit for repairs. He won't DNF, though.
Oh, look at Kyle Busch out there.
Yeah, he is all over the track.
I mean, what has gotten into him today?
Oh, that cannot be good.
Oh, unbelievable.
Whoa, look out.
Wait a minute. Is Kyle in reverse?
Yeah, you don't see that every day. Okay, that is bad,
man.
Bad driving.
This is not like Kyle at all.
Are we winning?
I thought you were looking.
M&M's makes race day more fun.
What is Kyle thinking?
On this restart, we are going to have 10 laps to go. Will they stay green to the end? You will have to see. With the field thinned out a little bit, we go green flag. Chastain with another great restart, but Logano tries to battle back on the outside, on the backstretch. Can Logano get in front of Chastain? It looks like he gets a little bit of run, and yes, he does. Now that outside lane is going to start a little bit of a train. Logano getting pushed by Buescher. Buescher tries to go to the bottom, gets put in the sucker hole, and now they're three wide. Three wide for the lead. Austin Dillon out of nowhere getting pushed by Daniel Suarez, who also came out of nowhere. And Daniel Suarez jumps out to the inside, and he will take the lead. Chastain's pushing him, along with Bell, Logano, and Blaney on the inside. Suarez starting a little bit of a train on the inside. Dillon leads the top, but they're single file for the first five or so cars. At 14 of 20. It might get pretty chippy when they get to around the last five laps or so. I wouldn't be surprised if somebody jumps up and you're like, there we go, right there, Kyle Busch, right there on the bottom lane. He might start a little bit of a run and try to rival that outside. It looks like Kevin Harvick's going to have to come in again for repairs. It looks like Christopher Bell's going to jump down with his Joe Gibbs teammate, and they're going to be three wide. Chastain and Suarez on the outside, trying to battle Bell and Logano on the other two inside lanes. Bell has almost no help, but he's still in it. Logano help from two Fords behind him. That special kind of chemistry it's really going to give him good pushes. But Logano's going to jump down to the bottom. It's not going to help, as Blaney's now getting a run from Matt DiBenedetto. Matt DiBenedetto, I don't know where he came from, but now he's here. Three laps to go on the backstretch. Anthony Alfredo somehow into the mix now. Blaney might try to jump into the inside here, but he can't. Two laps to go. Suarez tries to block middle. He gets shoved up the track. Here comes Anthony Alfredo on the top line getting pushed by Suarez. Bubba Wallace is up here in the top five now. Anthony Alfredo leads the Daytona 500 as he comes to the final lap. Oh, Blaney in the wall. Suarez gets spun around on the front stretch. About two turns left onto the back stretch for the final time. Anthony Alfredo gets turned. and a huge wreck on the backstretch that will end this race. Alfredo, Blaney, Chastain, Logano, Wallace, and more involved. Huge wreck on the backstretch. Let's see this replay. After Suarez spun, it looks like they almost got three wide. Anthony Alfredo gets loose and goes right into the back of Blaney. It looks like Stenhouse, DiBenedetto, Truex, Wallace, Logano, Chastain, Blaney, and Alfredo were all in it. But now we have to see who's going to win. Any of these four cars could have done it. It's who was in the lead at time of caution. Now, we're going to show the replay again. We're going to pause it at the time of caution. Remember, any wrecked car does not count. As you can see, all those wrecked cars are X's. It looks like Austin Dillon is going to win. He was the lead car at the time of caution. It looks like Austin Dillon, yes, it's official. Austin Dillon wins the CRA Season 4 Daytona 500. And heartbreak for many other teams. See the replay one last time. Looks like Alfredo, Chastain both kind of get loose, and then it's all just chaos from there. Austin Dillon doing a little burnout there in his Cheerios number 3. Well-deserved win for him. Looks like all the drivers are okay, which is a great thing to see, especially on wrecks like those. Now, here we're going to give you your race results. Some pretty surprising. Everybody wanna steal my girl. Everybody wanna take her all the way. Couple billion in the hole.